It's tied to capture. Hello everyone, can you hear me? Hopefully you can. If you can, let us know. We've been having some stuff going on. I mean, there's always stuff going on. Anyway, here we are, 8:30 Friday. Thanks for tuning in. So I just thought I'd get into, you know, why I was doing this basically, and I thought, you know, what with everything going on, you know, we're all locked down again, perhaps when it happened last time. We didn't expect to be, you know, maybe this is a way of giving you something to do when we're all stuck indoors. And it also gave me an opportunity to kind of like go back through, you know, some of these songs, which definitely we haven't played live for a long time. And, you know, I haven't, you know, actually sat and worked and, you know, figured them out again for a long time. So that's good for me, and hopefully it'll be interesting for you too. Obviously, it's not going to be like, you know, those hard-fi shows of old, because it's just me, just an acoustic guitar. I'm at home. Right up there, right above my head, is a little girl who's 3 years old, hopefully fast asleep. She's one of the angriest people I know. And three things make her angry: her brother, getting woken up, and being hungry. And there's something that we all need to be aware of. She didn't eat her dinner. So we're going to try and not awake the kraken. So I might sort of, you know, it might be less hard fi, maybe more smooth fi. Easy fi, perhaps, if you will. So that's going to be the kind of vibe. It's going to be sort of a different take on some of the songs. Some of you, I haven't noticed in the comments, are thinking about playing along with your guitar. So that's nice. Changed a few of the keys, though. Just a little heads up for you, because they work better on the guitar and, you know, that kind of thing. I'll let you know in advance. And, you know, if you've got any questions, I don't know what, you know, I've probably got more questions for you about all sorts of things. But if you've got any questions, if you've got any shout-outs, then, you know, put them in the comments, and a bit later on we'll see if we can read a few of them out and see what's going on. So, yeah, okay, well, I suppose we ought to. And then, oh, yeah, the other thing was, like, the running order, right? So the whole point is that we're going to do Stars of CCTV, the whole album, which I have here. Here it is. I also wrote in the comments, this is worth 80 quid now. That's a result. So anyway, this lineup here is kind of, you know, this worked for the record. You know, you've got like Hard to Beat here. That's like the strong song at the end of side A. So it's not really, I'd like to have done it like this, but it's not really kind of conducive to a kind of a live set. Because there'll be some of you, after I've done Hard to Beat, you'll chip off. You've got to leave the good ones to the end. Get the last train home or something. So, anyway, so I've moved it around a little bit, but I am going to start with Cash Machine. And then it sort of goes roughly in a... Actually, looking at it now, no, it doesn't. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Too late now. Right. So obviously, when we were doing the shows, we'd often start with "Man with a Harmonica" by Ennio Morricone. Obviously, we lost Ennio Morricone last year. Wolsey White is the guy who produced "Stars of CCTV." "Stars of CCTV" with me. You know, he really made it come together, and we both loved Ennio Morricone. I mean, we thought he was fantastic. And anyway, so I was just trying to remember, you know, the intro music. And we had this big backdrop which said "Hard Fight in Operation," big yellow and black thing. And they strung up this black sheet in front of it. And then in the music, it all builds up to a crescendo. And it hits this bong. And on that, the guy, it's all smoke and mirrors magic to me, but he'd press the button and the black sheet would fall down and all the lights would hit on the backdrop. And, you know, we'd be waiting backstage to go on. And we'd hear like the crowd, you guys, go mad, and it was fantastic feeling. It was about then that I decided I needed to go to the toilet, generally, which was a risky business needed to go to the cars. It ended up being called the kamikaze because there was literally seconds before we had to be on. So anyway, I'm going to get on with it. I don't know why I'm telling you that, really. Now, listen, again, if you're anything weird or you can say, hey, listen, turn up this, turn down that, please let us know because I can adjust it. As I say, we had everything working, right? And then today we go to do it and Facebook is saying, hey, we've changed everything. I'm like, oh, terrific. So we've had to do it a different way. Hopefully everything's in sync and it's all working and I'm going to get on with it. Go to a cash machine, get a ticket home, a message on the screen. You're broke, no moments can be right. I know the times is tight. I've only just been paid 3 weeks, 5 days till I'm seen. No, I scratch a living, it ain't easy. You know it's a drag. I'm always paying, never making, but you can't look back. I wonder if I'll ever get to where I want to be. You better believe it, I'm working for the cash machine. Ooh. I try to phone a friend, myself with batteries dead. I try to skip the fair, ticket inspectors there. No notice can't be right. I live an honest life. Seems like sometimes you don't cross the line, you don't care. That's all sounding all right. I'm going to move straight on. Yeah, cool. Good. Okay. Got a reason then. All around
enough. Seen us move, but on the counter up. I got a reason. No, I got no reason. Let's go on the radio. I ain't got no place to go. I got no reason. No, I got no reason.
But wait.
See the new girl in town. Maybe I can shout you round, oh baby. Let's generate some. I got a reason to do, do, do. Now I got a reason to do, do, do. Hey, hey, baby, you're not me. Made me wanna scream, made me wanna shout out. I got a reason to do, do, do. Now I got a reason. Face girl, I like your style. You got a reason. Now I got a reason. You look so good. I want to eat you up like food. Oh baby, let's generate some. I got a reason. Now I got a reason. Just right, gonna make my move tonight. I got a reason. Now I got a reason. Now I got a reason. Now I got a reason. Got a reason.
Thank you very much. Okay, so that went fairly smoothly so far, I think. I'll get into this later on, but I actually hate doing acoustic sessions because it's really nerve-wracking. But anyway, so funnily enough, got a reason that when I wrote that didn't actually. I didn't see it as being a hard-fire tune. I sort of did it. It was almost a little bit of a joke because it was a sort of like a, you know, bit of a garage punk thing, right? You know, that's why the line in there, you look so good, I want to eat you up like food, right? So, but I did it, and it took like, you know, 10 minutes to write, and the demo took about an hour or two because it was really quick, and often, you know, that's kind of a good sign. So I just thought, you know, it's just something to, I don't know why. And then I played it to some people, and they all loved it. And Woolsey White, as I mentioned before, the guy who produced the record, that was the first one he heard it. He said, "I want to do that one first." He loved it. So we went into our little studio, Cherry Lips, and we did all the drums properly and everything else with the guys. And then he did it, worked his magic. And it's like, oh my god, that starts to actually sounds like a proper record, you know. And it was a really good feeling. It was like, this actually could, you know, be something. I don't know, you know. And I think I must have been listening to like the Hives, I think, something like that kind of thing. I remember seeing the Hives. They were a terrific live band, and they always make me think of Rocket from the Crypt. So if you remember Rocket from the Crypt, they had that track, on a rope, got me hanging on a rope. And I saw them at Reading, and I think they were doing that number, and there's like, they've got a brass section in the band, so there's quite a lot of them, and they're playing it, and all of a sudden they stopped dead, right? Completely still, no sound, nothing. And they sat there, and they were like that for like some time. I mean, it was like everyone standing there, and you sort of, and then like, you know, off on stage, it must have felt like hours, but still statues. It was amazing. And then they kicked back in, everyone together, no kind of, no tee up. I don't know how they did it. If we had tried to do it, it would have been a complete shambles, right? But it was so fucking cool. I remember that. And it made me think, actually, you know, this whole lockdown really makes you appreciate, you know, going to see music live, going to see, especially those bands that are just fun and great, you know, how much I miss it, and how much, you know, hopefully when everything gets back to normal, and it will get back to normal, know, we've got to get back out there and go and see some shows. I've heard someone say that it's going to be like the Roaring Twenties. I mean, people keep saying that, but I don't know. Let's hope there's no World War III in the 30s, that's what I say. Right, anyway, so I'm on, of course, Cash Machine. Yeah, so that was like our first little record we put out on Necessary Records. And we did our funny video for it. If you haven't watched it, it's on YouTube. We never actually did get into Heathrow. I mean, that was a story, but obviously we would have been shot on sight probably. It was just over the fence from Heathrow. So sorry if I've just burst your bubble with that. But that came together really quickly. But it used to, in fact, yeah, I found this the other day. This is my book that I had. I used to write everything in. It's got a Radio 4 sticker on the front there. And I found the original lyrics, which you probably ain't going to be able to see this, but where is it? Here it is. Marked out by a Sleepy Jackson ticket. Does anyone remember Sleepy Jackson? Anyway, you're not going to be able to see this, but they're kind of all there with the original lyrics there and all the sort of, you know, what tempo it was and all this kind of thing. And I think I had it in there as ripping off a Cash Machine. And Warren Clark, who is Mr. Necessary Records, who, you know, helped make all this happen, he said, oh, you should be working for the Cash Machine. And of course he was right, so we did that. And I've got other stuff in here. That's the lyrics for Film Singing Out. I'm probably going to do this and drop everything. You can't see that, I know, but... look, here we go. It said it's called Out of Control there. I was trying to find some of the old computer files and stuff like that, and they've all got different names. Well, look, here's the Hardfire Band Registry details. I'm not going to show that, it's got my password. Anyway. Maybe I'll photograph some of that and put it up. I want to get on with it, otherwise we'll be here all night. So I hope you've got a drink. I hope you've got some headphones on as well, probably just listening through your phones. I haven't had a drink for 15 days. What's the time? 9 hours. I'm going to have one after this. So if I start speeding through it, you know why. Right, anyway, let's get on with it. This is Middle Eastern Holiday.
Deal to the sun, everything is inclusive. We pull it holes, scatter minerals. We'll count the horizon, a beautiful sunset. I'm going on my Eastern holiday. Ain't gone so long. I hope I see my mom again. I'm going on my Middle Eastern holiday. Give me a con. I hope I'm coming home someday. Tonight I'm drinking and dancing. I've gotta go. Is she missing me? Oh, watching our family on the news on TV. I'm going on my Middle Eastern holiday. Yeah. I hope I'm coming home someday. Coming home someday. could have spent for me. Time seems to stand still, I'm so scared I can't speak. I'm flying hope, hope of everything. I don't understand why is my mother crying. I'm going on. I hope I'm coming home someday. I'm going on my Middle Eastern holiday. Yeah. I hope I see my mom again. I'm going on my Middle Eastern holiday. Top of the town. I hope I'm coming home someday. Don't conform, get me out of here. Leave the bottom behind. Wanna see the bright lights. Get this thing in gear. So we'll ride in my car. Follow the star, drive on into town, in a town with the stereo loud. Take the great west road out. Nothing can bring me down, bring me down. I said,
your coja boots on.
Can't you feel the blood rush, baby? Tied up too tight. Oh, can you feel it? Feel the city breathing. Heart. No superstition, just cold ambition. It's time to make a mark, make a mark.
Put your boots on.
Sing na 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 na, straight out of Westland, na 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 na, just like a loaded gun, na 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 na. The county shit, they don't like us, they don't like us, no no no, na 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 na. We'll hit this trip tonight, na 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 na. Your eyes are burning so bright, na na na. Can't you feel the blood rush, baby? Tied up too tight. Tied up too tight. Tied up too tight. Can't you feel? feel the blood rush, tied up too tight. Can't you feel the blood rush, tied up too tight? Can't you feel the blood rush, tied up too tight? Can you feel the blood rush, tied up too tight? Can't you feel the blood rush, baby, tied up too tight?
Thank you very much. This is really weird because, like, obviously you're kind of assuming and hoping that people are watching this, but there's no one here, it's just us two, so, you know. So, Tied Up Too Tight, that was like our first proper major label release, and it charted and did better than we expected, and they have this thing called midweeks, right? So that's when they kind of get an idea about where you're going to go in the charts, and they release it. It's always a little bit higher than when it ends up, because obviously all the pop kids go out and buy their stuff for the weekend. At least that used to be before streaming, anyway, right? So, and we were doing the Live Lounge on Radio 1 with Joe Wiley. So that was like, I mean, that was, you have to go on there and you do like an acoustic version of your single. Hang on, get rid of all that. Yeah, you do an acoustic version of your single. And then you do like a cover, and that day we did White Stripes, Seven Nation Army, which we used to do live anyway, and we had to do a version of Tied Up Too Tight. And while we were rehearsing it, our completely amazing lady who used to sort of do all our radio promotion and TV promotion, Kate Burnett, came in and let us know that it had gone to, it was in at number 9, which was amazing. And we were down there in Maida Vale, the BBC got these studios down there. I mean, they, when you see them, they look a little bit, I think it used to be like, I think when it was built, it was like it was an ice rink or something like that, or a roller skating rink. And so everyone's been down there, all the John Peel sessions and stuff, so it was a big moment for us to be there. And it's weird, you never actually meet Jo Wiley because she's somewhere else, you just talk to her over the line, over the wire. But we had to do that tune. We had to do an acoustic version, and I kind of figured out that I don't like acoustic versions, because, you know, I like having Steve behind me, I like having Carl over there, I like having Ross there, and I like having you lot all there. This is kind of like well out of my comfort zone. But anyway, it's a tough life, isn't it? What's that? Oh well, we've got some people here from Brazil, Peru, Mexico, El Salvador, and Stanwell. All the exotic places. Hello, everyone. So that was tight. And then the weekend, it went in the charts. Finally, went in the charts number 18, which was like, you know, we were like, wow, this is amazing. And we were playing a gig at King Tut's in Glasgow, amazing venue. And we all got all so excited that we managed to have a fist fight on the way home because we all had too much to drink. And it all kicked off. So anyway, that was our first chart position, having a rumble on the M6. So that sounds a bit like a dogging thing, doesn't it? Wasn't that? Anyway, yeah, when we did the video, we wrecked Wolsey's car in the video. He was very disappointed about that. He won't like me for saying it, but it was an old banger, some BMW, and they took all the seats out to put a camera in it, and they never put it back together again. There was probably a few missing bits. And then we shot the video on a freezing cold AstroTurf pitch in Feltham and Western International Market. Actually, I realised later that the pitch in Feltham where we shot it was where some years before I went for a trial with Sunbury Celtic. And I never got picked, right? So who had the last laugh? Okay? Anyway. And then we went to Cheeky's and we did some stuff at Cheeky's. And I have to say quickly as well, because it's always bothered me a little bit. So we used to do interviews and you sort of just go on about everything. And, you know, you sort of expect it to be like the NME, you know. I describe Cheeky's as being like a bad wedding. I And what I meant was that they play all these tunes that are like guilty pleasures, you know, like Come On Eileen, which is an amazing song. You know, what's that Bon Jovi track, Come On, you know the one, right? It's just gone out of my head. Living on a Prayer. And they play all that, and so you have really good fun, but there's always a chance of a fist fight breaking out. So, and then, and I'll just talk, say all that nonsense whenever anyone asks me. And, but of course, it wasn't the enemy anymore. It was stuff like the Sunday Times and the Daily Mail. And then the owner of the club came up to me and said, why do you keep slagging off my club? And I really regret that, actually. I really wish I hadn't done that, because it wasn't fair, you know. I just didn't think, and I should have thought. But and it's gone now. It's closed. I don't think it's anything to do with me, but... you know, what happened was they changed the licensing laws, and everyone used to go and get completely tanked up in the pub and then go to the club for a good old fight. And they've knocked it down now, and the town is poorer for it. We haven't got any kind of thing like that. So so I'm sorry. Anyway, what can I say? I'm going to get on with it. Sorry. It's not quite a nice building as well, and they've just flattened it. They're going to build some flats so no one can live in them. Right. Bit of politics here. This is Felton singing out.
Friday night, have a drink and do whatever made us feel alright. Stay out all weekend, try taking everything, but never hurt no one. So why you only left once I thought, till I got pulled. That one enough for you. Go out Monday too, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, till it all caught up with you. You're everyone's best friend, long as they've got something. I did not know you no more. Heartbreak, a sickness I can't say. Felt on this, singing out. Felt on this, singing out tonight. Life's gone out. 21 years old and out. Felt on this, singing out. You can't hold down a job, so then you had to rob. First from your mom and then your friends and then the local shops. But as a criminal, you're just no good at all. You got your collar fouled, so dumb when you thought about skipping bail. Now you're in jail. Foul time is time is singing out tonight. A life's gone out. 21 years old and out. Out time is singing prison life. You love to watch the sky. You'll get beaten and you'll end up throwing up all night. You couldn't take no more, So when they close the door, tie yourself up, strung yourself up, and then you would know my, oh my. Every day I see a face as I walk on by past that awful place. 23 hours in a cell each and every day, just like a living hell. Living hell, felt summons singing out, felt summons singing out. It's in my lights gone out. 21 years old and now felt summons.
Playing along, of course, you'll notice that's the original key. That was E minor, not D minor, which I did it in D minor, because D minor is the saddest of all keys. So
let's keep going. No, I don't want that. I want that.
Right one, isn't it? I got distracted. Who's better do better for? Well, we'll answer these later. I was going to answer questions sort of like in a couple of numbers time, right? I'm going to start that again. I'm not going to be bamboozled. This is in the original key.
Thank you.
feel I need that you're free and oh, can you see me again? You're right, you've been kicked out. Do you think I'm that stupid? You say I feel a little, he just get tired of you, kid. I could not over the days. I cried so much, my face has never been the same. Now you're back here with your life. I hope you realize. You think I'm gonna take you back? You better do better than that. I tell you how it's gonna be. Don't you never ever come near me. Let me tell you how I've been. Hiding from my friends, hiding from the world, hiding from myself. I think I'll come around here, start singing in my ear. Could you damage me? I don't forgive so easily. You better do better than. You better leave, cause you see I won't be blamed for my actions. I don't know how I ever loved you. So dumb, but did I ever trust you? But you and you left at me, oh, hey. While you lay together, I could not live for days. I cried so much, my face has never been the same. And now you're back here with your life. You think I'm gonna take you back? You better do better than that. Tell you how it's gonna be. Don't you never ever come near me. Let me tell you how I've been hiding from my friends, hiding from the world, hiding from myself. Think you'll come around here, start singing in my ear. Girl, you damage me. Do better than that. Give you everything I had, girl, but you had to try and take some more on. You went behind my back, girl, cheated on me. I was the last to know. Did everything we have, girl, be nothing to ya. Well, I was such a fool. Now you can crawl it back, girl. Well, let me tell you, I am feeling you. I'm back up off the floor. I won't get hurt no more. I've been waiting for this day when you'll be back here with your lies. I hope you realize. You think I'm gonna take you back? You better do better than that. I'll tell you how it's gonna be. Don't you never ever come near me. Let me tell you how I've been. I've been hiding from my friends, hiding from the world, hiding from myself. You think you'll come around here, start singing in my ear. Could you damage me? I don't forgive so easily. You better do better than.
It was better, do better about. Well, it's kind of one of those strange things where I didn't really write it about anyone, I just wrote it. And then it kind of came through word for word later. That's kind of happened a few times, a few songs that I've written. I just sort of write them and the words come out, and then later on it all sort of happens. I'm going to write one called I've Won Euro Millions, just see if it works. A lot of people have been asking about, because obviously I was waving this around. And people have been asking about a... are we going to reissue it? So, we have been thinking about it. Seriously thinking about it. And, you know, we've been thinking about... I've been talking to the guys, and at some point, you know, we would like to do some shows again. And, you know, we don't know when, we don't know what, how it would work out, but we're all up for that. And maybe when we do, we'd reissue the album. I mean, it's all kind of complicated with everything going on. I mean, some of you may know that last year I was doing I made an album with some friends of mine, which we called Offworld, and we were in the middle of putting that out. And Offworld is Wolsey White, stars a CCTV producer, he plays guitar. Kristen Cummings, some of you will know her, she's sung backing vocals on a lot of the tracks on the third album, Killer Sounds. And she often turned up with us live and did those, some of the sessions we did, she was sung on those. And she is, you know, Kristen is incredible. And I did a session with her, it's on Facebook, you can go back and see it, back in, we did one for the Royal Albert Hall back in April. And then we did one here again when all the gear didn't work, same as usual. You know, she is like back. You know, she's been on Broadway. She's been in West End, like in lead roles in major productions. If you go clubbing, you'll hear a tune and she'll be singing on it because she's done loads of that stuff. And she is just amazing. Like, just playing with her and watching her do her thing is incredible. So she's in it. And then Smiley Barnard, who I first saw playing drums for Intimate Strangers in at the Compasses. And I thought, oh, he's good, isn't he? You know. And then the next thing I know, I'm watching Top of the Pops, and Robbie Williams is on. Oh, that's that fella from... And he's playing with Robbie Williams, right? And then you know, time passes, and the next thing I know, he's playing with Joe Strummer. He's played with everyone, so he's this incredible drummer. And then Dale Davis, who was Amy Winehouse's bass player and a musical director. He's done lots of other stuff, but... So we had this thing, and it was like great fun, and we made a record, and we've even got around to putting like a few tunes out. You can go and listen to them. Offworld is on Spotify. Offworld Sounds on YouTube, and we're gonna put the rest of the record out at some point. We've got some shows in the summer, hopefully, with the specials, and hopefully we'll have some rescheduled festivals and what have you. So, first of all, please go and check out the Offworld stuff because we're really pleased with it, and we're really happy with it. I think it's good. So yeah, go and check that out, and you can also go and follow us on the Facebook page, Offworld Facebook page, Offworld Sounds, Instagram, Offworld Sounds, Twitter, Offworld Sounds, and there's a website, offworld.uk. So if you want to hear some new music, I know it's not Hardfire, but it's sort of come from the same place with some cool and fun and interesting people on it, check that out. So we want to do that, but obviously, you know, me and the guys want to get out and do something. To that end, actually, we've set up a new web page, and because our other one, hard-fire.com, someone pinched it. Right? How does that work out? I got that years ago, and then the major label got hold of it, and then before we know it, you go on there and they're trying to flog you. I don't know what. Anyway, so we got a new one. It's called hard.fi. Get that? Hard.fi. And it's just like a holding page at the moment. Just put some pictures up, just put it up to get it up. But there is a mailing list on there. So if you want to hear about, you know, reissues, if you want to hear about gigs and new stuff, you know, it might be a while, go on there and put your email address in. I promise you we won't send you loads of stuff, loads of crap. It'll just be, you know, news about Hardfire, maybe about some off-world stuff. But go in there. And I know some of you have already, you know, you signed up to the email mailing list years ago. I've still got that. There's about 25,000 names on it. How many of those still have the same email address? I don't know. But and we need to use it. But it's like £1,000 to like send out one email. So there's probably some people on here who are a lot cleverer than I am. If you know a cheaper way of doing it, then you know we can get on there and say, hey, are you still here? Do you want us to keep sending you stuff or not? And we can keep you up to date. I mean, we'll tell you stuff that's going on Facebook and Twitter and Insta. By the way, there's a new Hardfire Instagram page, Hardfire Official, which I will get around with. I just found loads of cool photos that, you know, hard drive stashed away. So go on there. So, yeah, go on, you know, go and, if you don't mind, go and leave your email address. You know, as soon as we know what we're doing and we figure it out, you know. We'd like to do some new music. We'd just like, I think we'd like to do some shows at some point because, you know, we miss it. It was fun. Well, I'm gonna do another couple of numbers, and then I'll answer any questions, do some shout outs, and see how we're getting on. So this next one is Unnecessary Trouble.
Safe.
to the gallery. I'm gonna get my face on the 6 o'clock news. With stars out, CCTV making movies out on the street. With stars out, CCTV, can't you see the camera loves me? We feel the screen, can't help but notice me. Gonna get my face on a 6 o'clock news. With the stars of CCTV making movies out on the street, flashing blue lights, camera action. Once in my life, main attraction. CCTV, can't you see the camera loves me?
Stars of CCTV, I mean, this, when we were doing this, just to show you this again, this was like the, that was the artwork. You can see that. That was the artwork on the original mini album. And that's outside our studio. And we thought, you know, it's like a CCTV camera. And then we went and did a photo shoot it was our first ever photo shoot, and Kai's girlfriend, Bernice, took the photos, and they're still some of my favourite photos, if you can see that. And at Tolworth Tower. I don't know where Tolworth Tower is. You're not missing anything. But while we were doing it, Warren was there, and he was just taking photos of us, having our photo taken. And he took a photo of a CCTV sign. And then we gave all the bits to Dave was doing the artwork, and he took that CCTV sign and he printed it on the CD. So that was the CD artwork. And it just like kind of never sort of really, well, that looks cool, isn't it? It never sort of dawned on us that, you know, actually it should be on the front. And I think it must have been those guys at the artwork who said, look, slam it on the front. And that was kind of all we always wanted. We always loved records like Screamadelica, that kind of real simple image, bright colours. And of course, you know, it's like, it just worked so well. You know, everyone was always saying they'll just see the signs everywhere and think of us. And there might have been some of you who went around sticking the stickers up everywhere. That was so cool. Thank you for that. Thank you for helping us out in the early days. You know, if it wasn't for you guys, you know, we wouldn't have got anywhere like we did. And we had loads of fun. Anyway, so just do some questions and some shout-outs. I feel like a radio jock doing some shout-outs. What's this? Okay, Jen Hughes. Happy birthday next week, Jen. Paul and the Wee and P and Staines, how you doing, guys? Nice to hear from you. Alina and Chris, how you doing? Danny and Elena, Sally and Honey, over there in Staines, how you doing? Hope everything's good. that was weird. Seemed like a good idea when I was thinking about it, but it's like kind of, you know, feels like a bit a Saturday morning swap shop. Has anyone got anything they want to swap? Anyone got any toys they want to swap? I've got an operation. I've got an operation is complete. If anyone wants to swap that for something, right. Anyway, so next one. This song was a big song for us, really. And maybe I should tune up. It was a big song for us. I didn't think of this earlier. Hard to Beat, you know, and that was the one that, you know, everything started to move from. And I remember Axwell did a remix of it, which I'm sure you know and I've heard it. And we were in Ibiza doing it was the very first Ibiza Rocks. And at that time, they didn't have a venue, they did it in one of the nightclubs, it was in Manumission. And it was kind of weird because they weren't really set up for it. And there was us and, oh man, I always forget the guy's name. Anyway, someone will know. If someone knows, send us and let me know. And it's basically like a big nightclub. And in Manumission, you know, it's quite full on, right? So there was just basically topless dancers around everywhere. And we were due to go on probably about midnight. We didn't go on until about 5 in the morning. Everyone was off their heads. I mean, no one had a clue who we were, you know, so, but it was an amazing experience. I think I said this before, it's a shame, really, because when they went to the sort of, like, standard venue route, it didn't feel as if we'd always love that mix of club and rock and music, you know, we wanted to be maybe the sort of band that you listen to when you came home from the club or something like that, and we always loved having remixes. You know, it's great having Wrong Tom along with us, because, you know, he started out, when we did the mini album, Wrong Tom was that he was going to be like a DJ, like Grand Theft Auto. He was going to be in between the tunes, and we recorded that, we've got it somewhere, maybe we should put it out. We scrapped it in the end. I mean, I always remember my favourite one was he went, shout out to Warren, you Ginger Prince. No one else would get that, but Tom used to do just some amazing, like, you've heard some of them, they're out there. Him and Wolsey did some great ones. If you haven't seen the DVD for Live in Operation, which is Us at the Astoria, those were great shows around Christmas, Christmas 2005. There's some mixes on there. The Wolsey did some, and sort of Wrong Tom, and obviously Wrong Tom used to be our tour DJ as well. So it was always great, because he was always playing some amazing music and introducing us to amazing music. I think he introduced me to House of Jealous Lovers by Rapture, which kind of inspired Cash Machine, actually. And Middle Eastern Holiday, probably, for that sort of bass line in there. But anyway, move on now. So one other thing. Brentford used to come out to Hard to Beat, right? And they stopped. What's going on, Brentford? I mean, I can't remember. I think they come up to the Prodigy now. I can't remember because I've not been there. But, the Prodigy, they're great, right? Are they Brentford fans? It doesn't bother me, right? It doesn't bother me. Right, and also, key fans. This one is not... It's the original was in G minor. This one is in F sharp minor, down a semitone, because it's just easier to play on a guitar. All right. So if you can... if you can fill up a plastic cup with beer, jump around and then throw it around your living room, recreate the experience, go for it. I'm seeing you hanging round town, you in a
girl, you got something I like. Walk right over, said, "Hi, how you doing?" You smiled at me, girl, it's alright for me. I said, "Come on, let's dance. We've got to take our chance." You whispered in my ear, "You wanna get out of here?" Can you feel it? Rocking the city, yeah. Straight out of nowhereness, like a fist. Can't resist you, oh no. I tell you something, you know I love ya. Just wanna touch ya, stand up, knock me right off my feet. Had to pay, had to pay, had to pay. I'm beating so fast that you tear my shirt off. This girl I saw around town, well now she's going down. Stuck on our losing streak, I think you turned it round. Oh yeah, girl you got something I like. Read all about it, have you heard the latest? Boy in a band, dates Hollywood actress. But that ain't you and me, we came up from the street. Time to hesitate, we gotta punch our way. Can you feel it? Rocking the city, yeah. Straight out of the witness, like a fist. Can't resist you, oh no. I tell you something, you know I love ya, yeah. Wanna touch ya, stand up, knock me right off my feet. How to pay, how to pay. Had to pay. Goodness, no, I've never known a night like this. Can't believe it. You're so hard to be, hard to be. Drive me crazy, my beautiful baby. Let's spend our whole day right here. Oh, I love ya, yeah. Wanna touch ya, stand up, knock me right off my feet. Had to pay, yeah. Had to be, yeah, I love ya. Yeah, I love ya. Yeah, I love you. Yeah, I love you when I'm sitting at home. Sitting at home, sitting at home. I love you, I love you. Girl, you got something I like. Something, something I like.
Wolsey suggested that we should do that as lockdown version. Can you feel it rocking the settee? So if you've got any other puns, send them in. A bit late now, I guess, but yes, right. Anyway, I hope that this is not dragged on too long, God knows. And I hope this has made this lockdown a little bit more interesting for you. And if you've enjoyed it, you know, maybe you could chuck a couple of quid the way of crisis or shelter, perhaps. Or, I mean, even, you know, when I think back to the tours we used to do, right, the bigger tours we did, you know, there was we had like a truck, right, we had a guy driving the truck. I mean, we weren't even allowed two trucks. And, you know, and we sort of, and there was guys and girls unloading that stuff. They'd be setting the massive PA up at every venue. They'd be doing the lighting rigs. There'd be people doing the you know, the catering, four or five people, and then you've got the lighting guy, and you've got the sound operative, you've got the drum tech, you've got the guitar tech, you've got the everything else tech. Right, there was a lot of people all doing that show, and all those guys and girls, they haven't, you know, they haven't worked for almost a year, so you know, I meant to find, there must be an organisation, Musicians Union will have something, if you feel like it, I know a lot of people are struggling, so obviously don't worry if you are, but if you feel like, you know, throwing them a couple of quid, that would be much appreciated. So, you know, and, you know, when touring does happen again, and it will happen, things will get better. Get out there, let's get out there, you know, and enjoy it again and revel in it again, because, you know, it's, you don't really realise what you've got until it's gone. I actually had a dream the other night about being in the pub. It wasn't a great pub, it wasn't a flash pub, bog standard, but it was a great dream. Anyway. My bedroom window, see the planes take off from Heathrow. One by one they come and go, on and on, on and on. I think about the places I'd go, think about this place I call home. All the shots and all the con, all around, all around. Red light blinking in the twilight, tracing out a path. Here and now. Red light blinking in the twilight, tracing out a path right out of here and now. Baby, baby, I think it's time we move on. It's quiet around here, doesn't seem so much to hear. Think back to this time last year, good times, good times, good times. Don't you think the color has gone? Don't you think it's time to move on? Yeah. Get on a plane, it can't be wrong. Moving on, moving on. Red light blinking in the twilight, tracing out a path right out of here now. Red light blinking in the twilight, tracing out a path right out of here now. Baby, baby, I think it's time we move on now.
Clubs have all closed down, nothing's going on around here. Well, it's time we left town. Got a feeling, my love, we gotta get out.
Thank you. So, thanks so much for joining us tonight. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you liked it. It's a little bit rough and ready, but that's the way things are. So, I hope you enjoyed it. Please think about leaving us your email address. Think about checking some off-world stuff out. If you want to go back and see the little session Kristen and I did, and keep an eye out for that. I want to say thank you to Alan Moore as well, who fixed my guitar for me in COVID-safe conditions. Nice one, Alan. Thank you for that. I want to say thank you to Chloe, who sat there doing everything, doing all the controls, writing stuff down, making sure all this kind of still works. Got to say thank you to, the NHS people, all those people, they're busting their balls there. Thank you to the teachers. I know I've been doing some homeschooling, right? And I kind of feel that they were shat on a little bit, the teachers, and they deserve a bit more. So thanks to those guys. Thanks to all those people who, we can order stuff. The guy who comes and delivers stuff, they're still going, those guys. People in the supermarkets, all those people, we really appreciate it. So for everyone locked down, for everyone in hospital, if you're in there right now getting over COVID, or if you're in for other reasons, I want to say hello to Barbara, my next door neighbour, who's not very well and she's in hospital. Get well soon, Barbara. We want to see you home. This next one's for you. Things will get better. Key fans, it's in F sharp, right? It's just a lot easier to go like this. That was shit, but you get the general idea. So anyway, thanks again. Last one, obviously, it's Friday night. I generally do some long spiel about, let's have it. So if you feel like having it, let's do it. All right.
Toilet window, drop to the floor, cool as ice through the door. I'm on fire, working out of time, working such a bind. Got some money to spend, I'm living by the weekend. When it gets too much, I let fire rush. Got some money to spend, I'm living by the weekend. It's there. Pressure pushing down. I'm living by the weekend.
you very much. Take care, guys. See you again soon. And just want to remember, Dave Teep, where are you? Bye-bye.